Hi, happy Sunday everybody. Welcome back to my channel, The Yorkshire Sew Girl. For any of you lovely people that are coming back to me, hello. For anybody that's new that's watching this, then welcome, welcome, welcome. If you would like to watch this again, if you do like it, you might be like, not bothered whatsoever. If you do, then please do subscribe below and click the notification bell, because I'm not that far off 1,000 subscribers. Who would have thought it? I think I was dead excited when I got 50. So yeah, you can imagine what I'm like now. I'm nearing the 1,000 bracket. But yeah, so welcome. Today I'm going to go through everything that I made in November. And I'm happy to say that I actually made everything that I planned, which is a miracle. Oh yeah. I was really determined this month, and I've had quite a lot of extra time because obviously we're not going out. We're not doing anything particularly at the minute. And it was lockdown 2.0 for the UK throughout the whole of November. So why not sew stuff? Why not? So yes, yeah, so I was quite productive. I made quite a few things altogether, which I'll go through now. And then I also did a little sneaky one as well, because I did a pattern test for somebody, my first one I've ever done. Obviously, I can't talk about it yet. I think it's going to be released hopefully sometime this month, and then I can show you. But yeah, I did a really nice pattern test, which was good fun. So I managed to sneak that in as well as everything else. So yeah, it's been really productive. So the first thing I made was what I'm wearing today, which is the Sewhouse 7 toaster sweater. Just stand up so you can see. A little bit longer at the back. It's got a little split hem, long sleeve version, and then this high neck here. So the, I'll show you the pattern. This is the pattern here. I think most people have kind of seen this before, but for anybody who hasn't, and there's two different versions here. There's one with a big neck, high neck, and then banding around the arms, around the sleeves and the hem, which is really nice. But I went for this one to start off with because I've seen a load of really nice versions, and when I bought this fabric, I was like, I know exactly what I want to make with it. So I did this version here. I've made it with a lovely jacquard knit, leopard print, obviously, from Sewsewsewuk. And it doesn't take an awful lot of fabric either, which is really good. So the measurements for this go from a 31 inch bust, 23 and a half inch waist, and a 34 inch hip, all the way to a 47 bust, 39 and a half waist, and a 50 hip. Now, just for frame of reference, I'm 5'9", tall girl over here. It's very good when I go to a gig though, because everybody else is jumping trying to see, and I can see over everybody, including men sometimes. So, you know, there are benefits to being tall. The only disadvantage is I had to wear flip-flops to my wedding because my husband's the same height as me. So, although he does say he's taller than me, but he genuinely isn't taller than me. He just kind of likes to say that he is. But anyway, so I am a 39 bust, a 34 waist, and a 42 hip. So I had a good look at the body measurements, and then I had a look at the finished garment measurements as well, because I don't really like anything particularly oversized unless that's the exact look that I'm going for. I much prefer something a little bit more fitted. So my bust measurements actually came out as a large on here. So a medium is 35 to 36 bust, and I'm a 39, and the large is a 37 and a half to a 39. So I was really veering on the edge of large as well, the highest one. But when you look at the finished measurements on version 2, a medium is 43 inches around the bust, so that gave me 4 inches of ease. So I kind of thought, you know what, I'm just going to go with a medium, and I'm really, really glad I did. It's a lovely pattern to sew up. It's a really quick make. I'm definitely going to make more of them. The only thing that I didn't do quite right, and it's annoying me a bit, it's a good job I've got long hair, is if you can see here, I don't know if you can see it there a lot, when you lay the fabric at the beginning and you lay it flat, didn't take enough care with that bit. So then when I actually stitched it in, and then you have to stitch in the ditch along here as well, I didn't realise until later on in the construction process that it wasn't quite lying flat. So it lies flat lovely across the front, but at the back there's a little kink in it. So, you know, put your hair over it. No one will know. No one will know, except for you lot, because I've already admitted it to you. But it's got lovely long sleeves. It's so warm and cozy and toasty, i.e. toaster sweater. And yeah, I'll definitely make more. In fact, I've got some fabric already that I'm already eyeing up. And I do really like this version, so it might be another one of these. So that was the first thing I made. Absolutely loved it. Really, really glad. The second thing is what's hanging up here. Now, I can't insert any photos of this because this is actually a present for my mum for Christmas. But if you did watch my plans video, you'll know this is a beautiful viscose jersey from Guthrie Ghani that I purchased a while ago. And this is the Mandy Boat Tee by Tessuti Fabrics. So free pattern, really, really simple to put together, literally from doing it all right from the very beginning, cutting your fabric out, sewing it up is about, I don't know, an hour and a half, 2 hours. And it's a really lovely flowy top. So my mum's a little bit more petite than me on the top, but I went with the same size that I did before, and I'll talk through that actually if I've got it here. So this is the pattern. Like I say, it's a free pattern. It's lovely. It's got really nice drop shoulder to it as well, which I always find really flattering. And this goes from a sizing point of view from an XXS to a triple XL. So it's from a 32 inch bust, 27 waist, 36 hip, all the way up to a 45.5 bust, 41 waist and a 49.5 hip. So again, I came out in between a medium and a large, but as you can tell from the pattern, it's quite a loose fitting top, so I think you can kind of get away with it. So in the end, I went with a size 2. So it's in size 1, 2, 3 and 4. A size 2 is actually a small to medium, believe it or not. I mean, no one had ever called me a small to medium, if you know what I mean. But the finished width around the body, around the bust and the hips, is 47 inches. Well, I'm only 39 on the top and 42 on my hips, so I'm like, that'll do. And that's a small one. So I think it depends how you want the top to look. But I think you don't need to go too crazy with it because you're using like a really nice drapey fabric. So it hides a multitude of sins. It hides the whole mum tum thing that I have going on in particular. So yeah, really good pattern. That's the second one that I've made now, and I want to make more for myself. I just think they look really nice and put together depending on what fabric you use. But I also think it'd be really nice in some real nice plains, you know, as more loungewear, maybe with a pair of hoods and pants. So you're kind of looking a bit more put together, but really just slobbing out like we're all doing at the moment. Right, okay, so then third thing I make. Right, well, I'm going to say that this is actually four things that I've made all in one. I mean, go with me here. So I said I was going to make some pyjamas for my little boys, didn't I? Some Christmas pyjamas. And I did. So this is my littlest's. Oh, this gorgeous fabric from First Fabrics. This was from. So it's got little geometric Christmas trees on it. And I use red ribbing on the bands, the cuffs and the hem. And then the little trousers that go with it. Oh my God, he looks so cute. I'll put a little picture of him in it. But as soon as I'd made these, I made them over a weekend for both my boys. They wanted to wear them. And I'm like, no. Not for Christmas. You can't possibly wear Christmas pyjamas now. My husband's like, shut up, Doylem. Doylem, I think that might be a Yorkshire term for anybody that hasn't heard that. I use it a lot because I'm a bit of a potty mouth, so I have to be really careful on here that I don't offend anybody. And then these are for my eldest. So these are in so similar fabric, but slightly different. So this has got a black background with the holly leaves and the geometric. Again, with the little red cuffs. And then I added these little Kylie and the Machine labels that say, "Yo, mama made it." So yeah, and the little trousers that go with it. So really, this counts as four things that I made, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Look at those. It's got long legs, my eldest. So yeah, I'm super happy with those. And the pattern that I used for those was a pattern by Made By Me Patterns. This is it here, if you see. And oh God, trying to measure children. Jesus. They're like octopus with eight chuffing arms, wiggling about all the time. I just gave up in the end. So all I did is I used the chart inside that showed the next size up from what my kids are. And you know what? They are a little bit big on them, but then I'm thinking bonus for next year as well. So yeah, so that's them. So I'd highly recommend them. I've also got a hoodie pattern and a sweatshirt pattern from the same company, and I'm going to try those as well at some point. But you know, all of that has been made for somebody else, which is like totally out of my comfort zone. So that's enough for 2020, is it not? Then I made this, which I love. Again, I'll try and put photos in wherever I can. And this is a Tilly in the Buttons Agnes top. And I love this. This is one of my favourite makes. This is a fabric that I've had my eye on for a long time. And it's an art gallery fabric. And for anybody who's ever sewn with art gallery knit fabric, you will know it is the best. So this is a really nice stretchy cotton jersey. And I went with the version of the puffy sleeves, obviously. So all you do is literally line up a little bit of clear elastic on the inside and then sew a zigzag stitch in, which creates this beautiful puffy sleeve. So it's dead simple. And the other thing you can do on this pattern is you can also put a little bit there to almost make it into a V-neck, which I think I might try next time just as something different. Now, in Tilly and the Buttons, I always make a size 6, which tends to fit me perfectly. So measurements on this go from a size 1 to 8, and a size 1 is a 30-inch bust, 24-inch waist, 33-inch hip, and the size 8 is a 44-inch bust, a 38-inch waist, and a 47-inch hip. Now, on a size 6, it's a 40 top. Well, I'm 39, so that's fine. A 34 waist, which is spot on for me, and a 43 hips, which again is just 1 inch bigger than mine. So I kind of lie in between a 5 and a 6 on the bust and hip. But the waist, I'm definitely a size 6. So it depends. I mean, you can grade between the sizes if you really wanted to, but I didn't feel the need to do that. I think because it's such a nice stretchy fabric as well. But I think now that I've sewn with that fabric, it's going to make me want to buy more, and it's really expensive. But it's the makes that I have done with really nice fabric that I reach for a lot. The ones that I've made with cheaper fabric, not so much. So I do need to consider maybe producing less with more quality fabric. Say stuff like this all the time and I never see it through. It's just a load of rubbish. Right, and then the next one, which was my last one, other than the little pattern test that I snuck in between, is another Tilly in the Buttons. And this is the Lotta dress. Again, I will put photos in. So this is the Lotta dress with my lovely little label that my friend got me that says handmade by the Yorkshire Sew Girl. Now, this was a really easy make, which surprised me. Don't make a lot of dresses, and I want to make more dresses. I love how you can put a dress on, tights, boots, you're kind of all done. There's none of this trying to work out what matches with what. So that is my aim for myself, is to start looking more at dress patterns. Obviously, when I saw this pattern come out, I was a bit like, no, that's definitely not for me. Not with the waist where it is, because it cinches you in at a certain part on your waist, and I'm quite thick waisted as such, so I was like, no, I don't think so. And then I saw so many versions on Instagram, and I was like, I'm gonna have to make it. So I purchased it just to kind of see what I thought. So this is the pattern here, for anybody who hasn't seen it. It's the Tilly in the Buttons Lotta dress, and you can do it in several different versions, so long sleeved, short sleeved, midi length, standard length. You can put pockets on it. It's got inseam pockets as well, which I didn't actually put in my dress, simply because of the type of fabric it was. So it's made out of it's called a viscose crepe that I got. And yeah, it's very static. So I've had to borrow a petticoat off my mum. Petticoat. I think some people suggested that on my videos when I was talking about what to do with it. And I do know that Liz from the Baker That Sews has made the Lotta dress in the green version of this, but a longer version, which is absolutely beautiful. So I decided to go for the shorter version, no pockets at all, which is unlike me because I do love a pocket, but I just kind of thought that with the fabric and that, I didn't know if it would suit it. And yeah, it was a really, really nice make. I was a bit annoyed with myself because when I ironed it a little bit, my iron was a little bit hot when I ironed here, and it's got a little bit of shine to it. You know when you do that? You get like cheap trousers or something. It's that. It's this fabric. And to be honest, I just don't know if I'm a massive fan of crepe fabric. It's hard to iron. You know, if you're trying to do your seams or anything like that, or you're trying to turn something over, your hem over, it just doesn't like it, does it? It just you iron it all and it just all pops back again. Kind of does my head in. But yeah, a really nice make. And actually, when I first put it on, I was a bit like, oh no, I'm not sure. But I think that's because I'm not used to wearing something like that. But the more I wore it, and I wore it to work, and I got a lot of compliments, which was really nice. Yeah, it's grown on me. And actually, I do think, because you can make this in woven as well, in knit as well, how nice would that be as like a lounge dress around the house? So you kind of feel a little bit dressed up, but you're not actually really like cosy and can like slob out in style. That's what I'm kind of thinking. So I might possibly have a go at a knit version at some point. I mean, I just have so many plans all the time. It's ridiculous. I have to write them all down, otherwise I'd never get to it. But yeah, it was a really nice make. The only thing for me is I'm not a massive fan of facings. I don't know about anybody else. Yeah, I'm just not a massive fan of them. I just hate the way they stick up all the time, even if you sew them into the seam and stuff like that. I don't know, maybe that's just a picky thing. But from a size point of view, again, this goes, actually I didn't realise, this goes from a size 1 to 10, when normally they go 1 to 8. So it goes from a 30 inch bust, 24 inch waist, 33 inch hip, all the way to a 48 inch bust, 42 inch waist and a 51 inch hip, which is really good, really good. You need quite a bit of fabric depending on which length you're doing. If you're doing the longer version, you need almost 3 meters, but you can do it at 2.5 for the knee length. And I think I did it out of slightly less than that when I think about it, when I cut it all out. But yeah, all you need is your fabric, a bit of interfacing and some elastic, and off you go. So yeah, I think it's a really nice pattern actually. And the thing with Tilly and the Buttons patterns is you can't go wrong for having a quick make, satisfying make. I find that they're quite good in between if you've done something quite complicated. So this month, I haven't really done anything complicated. I've done a toaster sweater, which sews up really easily, a Mandy Boat Tee, some pyjamas, an Agnes top, and that Lotta dress. So I think it's time for me to do something a little bit more taxing, but we'll see. So I've already done my December plans, which if you want to go and have a look, I'll try and link or learn how to put one of them weird things up here that comes out. Weird things. I don't know. Maybe that'll be my one task of what I need to learn for this week. You know, I like to try and learn something new for YouTube every week. Maybe that's what I'll do. So yeah, I've got quite a lot of plans for December, and I think I'm being very adventurous. So whether I get through them all or not, but one of them is the rear jacket by Mood. Not by Mood. Who's it by? Fibre Mood, that's it. And I think that'll be a bit more detailed construction, which I think is what I'm craving now. I've done quite a lot of quick, easy makes. So yeah, I want to try and push myself a little bit. So I think that'll be one of the things that I make for definite next month. And it's been really nice to see everybody's comments at the bottom of my YouTube videos. I absolutely love seeing what everybody says. I love everybody's opinions, and a load of people have come up with different suggestions from my December makes video, which I've already started considering. So yeah, thanks ever so much for leaving a comment. I really do appreciate it. I really enjoy reading everybody's and replying to everybody. And yeah, let's see how December goes. Obviously, it's a bit of a crazy month, isn't it, with Christmas? It's my eldest's birthday next week as well. So whether I get everything done or not, I don't know, but there we go. We'll see, won't we? So no reindeer glasses for you today. I haven't dressed up for you. Only thing is, I don't know if next time I do a video, you're actually gonna be able to see my eyes, because I really need my hairdresser so badly, but I'm not booked in for another week or two. But I literally, like, can you even see? I'm gonna poke myself in my eye with my own fringe soon, aren't I? But yeah, I'll just have to do this look, like, part my, hello. God, that's scary. did you do that, Ruan? Let's see if I cut that out anyway. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Not sure what my next video will be or when it goes up, but we will see. Hope to see you all back. I've been really enjoying watching everybody's Vlogmas. I've not done it this year because obviously I'm only quite new to YouTube, but maybe next year we shall see if you all want to be bored with my life. But actually, I've really enjoyed having a sneaky peek. It's like looking in someone's windows, isn't it, when you go past? You know, they've left the curtains open and the lights on. Is that just me? Is that just me that does that? Anyway, I'm fessing up to loads of people on YouTube, but I need to stop it. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully I'll see you again soon. Take care, everybody. I hope you have a lovely weekend and a fabulous Christmas, and hope to see you again soon. Bye.